Good afternoon. This is my laboratory. The main impact of my work has been to promote this laboratory to study processes, various kinds of processes. We can study both active and past processes. We have many different volcanic systems. They are of different types, about 35 of them, with calderas, central volcanoes, and major fissure swarms in response to the plate spreading in Iceland. Episodic earthquake activity, we try to combine geodetic studies with seismic studies to understand better and provide information to civil protection. We work very closely with civil protection and have been doing that in Iceland. One thing we realized when we started to get good GPS that the deformation fields in Iceland are complicated, mixture of many different processes, plate spreading, glacial isostatic adjustment, providing uplift due to current thinning of the Icelandic ice caps, resulting in large-scale uplift more than 2 centimeters per year. This information has been provided, for example, to road authorities to prepare roads in coastal areas. And we can say it's a laboratory because of the many different types of eruptions, normally every 3 years or so, explosive, effusive, closing Europe's airspace, like Eyjafjallajökull in 2010. We need to understand the precursors to eruptions like this. Icelandic eruptions are on the register of national hazards in the UK, so it is not only a hazard for Europe. In 2010, that was the first time we started to educate the civil protection in reading interferograms. Our colleagues in the civil protection, they understand interferograms. We provide information from interferograms to them. We have used the geodetic data to come up with some very complicated scenarios for recharging of magma bodies prior to eruptions, in this case for a period of 18 years. That led us to a large European project funded by the European Commission, 26 partners, Future Work. That was really important in preparing for the next set of eruptions. The aim included to improve delivery of information from scientists to society, and we have always tried to do that at the same time we advance scientific understanding of magmatic processes. During the middle of the project, we had this amazing activity, 2014 to 15, where we could study lateral dike propagation with a whole group of people in this Future Work project, learning how magma propagates in the ground, and also a caldera collapse. That was a highly exciting time, and used all kinds of geodetic data at meetings with the civil protection on a societal front. We have also a information hub on Icelandic volcanoes where you can go, icelandicvolcanoes.is. You will see one is on yellow alert. New name for you to remember, Öræfajökull, maybe the next one to erupt. Ice cauldron, increased geothermal activity, seismicity, some deformation. It's a stratovolcano, can produce powerful explosive eruptions. On the economical side, links with geothermal and the question, how good are our models for magma bodies in the crust? We have heard a lot about them. Sometimes we can do real testing of that by drilling into magma. This is from Krafla volcano in North Iceland, 2009, planned versus actual drilling into magma. And I think we can learn a lot. This is what happens when you drill into magma. This is a casing of a borehole that is being corroded when this well was tested. It had to be killed as well because there was not enough preparation. We want to do it again. Krafla magma testbed. I think it is an important initiative. We are looking for funding, including groups here in the UK, here in the US and UK and many places around the world. The purpose would be to understand better the links between hydrothermal system and magma, and includes a test sensor, put the sensors into magma, leave a thermocouple there to measure the temperature, would be a new time for volcano observations. Thank you.